Personality traits are not just descriptive patterns of behaviour. Trait theorists think that traits are the factors that are responsible for causing patterns of behaviour. They think that traits are things that reside in our brains. If you have some acquired brain injury from an accident or surgery or something like that, there can be quite substantial changes in personality due to the physical changes in the brain. Drugs may also affect your personality when they cause chemical changes in the brain. Now, how do we identify how many traits there are to describe personality? Well, to do that, we need to know how many dimensions of personality there are. What people have done is search through books, dictionaries typically, looking for words that describe temporary states relating to personality. Allport and Odbert in 1936 found 18,000 words from dictionaries describing aspects of personality and identified around 4,000 words for temporary states and social evaluations. You can then give people a questionnaire and ask them to indicate how many of those words apply to them. After that, you can perform a statistical test called factor analysis on the responses. Factor analysis tells us statistically what the minimum number of things are that we need to summarise the data. And that minimum number of things are the dimensions of personality. So imagine we can take all these words and get people to rate how much each of them apply in describing themselves. And with factor analysis, we can plot all of the responses and you can see if you need one dimension, two dimensions, or three dimensions, and so on to summarise the data. From the factor analyses researchers have conducted on personality measures, they seem to agree that there are between 3 and 16 dimensions of personality that are necessary for describing it.